is the one that says full auto. If you flip this up, your focus is auto, your white balance is auto, your iris is auto. You don't have any of the finessing. White balancing specifically, if there's this button, it's the square above the two triangles, that lets you manually set a white balance. But if you hit this white balance button, that throws it into auto mode, and then again, you don't have any control. We don't keep it. We like to have them set it at the top and then adjust if the settings on causes any immediate problems. Just to teach them the concept of, like, you're always changing as the light adjusts.
Yeah.
And then, did you? Okay, that's this. Did we get the feet in this house?
Yes, we have the feet. Nick just never connected it.
It happens.
What can we write down for?
Try to get
shelf hand.
Did you do a good work weekend?
I did.
Nice.
Yeah. We had a couple rain outs or stuff, so we had to, you know, we had to reschedule for like this week, but we had a little rain last week, so I had to shuffle them in. Shuffle. What's up there, big dog? How are you?
I'm good, how are you?
Good.
Ah, not bad. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. That was loud. 13, 14. How's it sounding down there? Hello, everyone. Welcome to Plymouth White Marsh School Stadium. Today we have the PW Colonials. Okay, cool. Thank you. So does yours. Do any of you have a picture, so I can take a picture of real quick? Thank you.
Still having a
not play for and then just look for them warming up.
Thank you.
Who would definitely not play both ways?
You want to play us?
Yep.
You want to play
middle
team?
School team?
Colton Galley.
You guys want to play
Colton Galley only
team?
Plays offense?
Football? Yes.
Yeah.
Offense. Thank you, sir. Appreciate it.
I'm kidding. We suck. All
right.
You guys would steamroll us.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Colonial Field for tonight's contest between the visiting Panthers of Cheltenham High School and your Plymouth White Marsh Colonial.
Okay. Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Plymouth White Marsh High School Stadium. As you can see, we have a very special broadcast today with the PW Colonials going up against the Cheltenham Panthers. Now, as they're going through the introductions for Plymouth White Marsh right now.
Number 65, Lewis Malvara. Offensive lineman, number 76, Colton Galley. Offensive lineman, number 54, Chris Kane. Offensive lineman, number 58, Zach Smith. At running back, number 44, Captain Nate Kern. At running back, number 3, Captain Zion East. At running back, number 2, Captain Chris McLaughlin.
Where was he first block?
At wide receiver, number 20, Phil Taramina. At the other wide receiver, number 24, Julian Williams. Your tight end, number 48, Jared Colson. And the quarterback, number 4, Aiden O'Brien.
And they just finished the introductions there for the starting lineup for the PW Colonials. Anyways, as I was saying beforehand, there's a great matchup on hand today between two teams that have been red hot recently. Plymouth White Marsh has not played since September 24th as they had a bye week last Friday, but in their last game they beat Springfield Township 35-14. They are 4-1. They lost their first game of the year and since have not looked back. They have not scored less than 27 points in a game, and they had three straight 40-point scoring games, including a 55-0 shutout.
At this time,
and they will be going on with
hats, caps,
the national
helmets.
Anthem, so we will take a quick break.
And please rise as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem. And we welcome our Plymouth White Marsh Marching Colonials. Ladies and gentlemen, our national anthem. Thank you.
And that was the national anthem brought to you from the PW Marching Band. And they had a performance before the game, about 20, 25 minutes beforehand. It was a great performance. I know they've worked very hard on it, and they did a great job with it. So picking off where we left off. So PW, we went over them. They've won four straight. They've been on fire. They had a bye week last week. Cheltenham, meanwhile, they are 3-3 on the year, but don't let the record decept you. They have won three straight games and have not scored under 30 points during this winning streak. Their last game was against William Tennant, where they won 36-24. And look, these are two teams that are very high-scoring teams. They are very dependent on their offense. And they're on fire, both teams. This is going to be a great matchup for homecoming. Tons of kids have already showed up. Plenty more are streaming in right now as we speak. There's a great energy around the stadium today.
What was the last one?
And we're hoping for a great game tonight.
Well, there's 228, so I'm not really sure how I
do it. There's a lot of neon in the crowd. Neon was today's theme. This entire week has been spirit week.
They have elected to defer to the second half. Colonials will receive to start the game.
And to begin the game, the Colonials will be receiving the kickoff from Cheltenham. And it looks like things are just about to get underway. We had a player doing a cartwheel on Cheltenham, it looked like, before going back. Very interesting pre-game ritual, I guess, but hey, if it works, it works. Both teams are gathered there at the end, talking their plans out. And there goes PW down to their side, where they will be receiving the ball. And it looks like we are just about getting ready to start things off. Cheltenham still talking things out.
Number 19, Devin Orensky.
Cheltenham is getting ready for the field now.
What was the name? Joshua Grady.
Kicking off for the Panthers, number 16, Joshua Grady.
And here's Joshua Grady for Cheltenham, ready to kick the ball off to PW as we're ready to get this game underway. Devin Orensky and Chris McLaughlin are back there for PW, ready to receive the ball. And here's the kick. It's deep, it's caught by McLaughlin, and they pass it off to Orensky. He makes a nice run down the field. He's up to the 40, he's up to the 50. He's getting down to Cheltenham's territory, and what a start to this game as he is on the Cheltenham 40.
The ball taken by number 2, Chris McLaughlin, then reversed to number 19, Devin Orensky, takes the ball.
A great pass off play there from Chris McLaughlin to Devin Orensky. And they're going to start this game with a decent chance to score here if they can keep advancing down the field. If this is a sign of things to come for PW, they could have a great game today. But of course, Cheltenham, they're a relentless team, and they're going to make it just as hard on PW as well, I imagine. And there's the play. It's a running play. And started to break some field. Aiden O'Brien. Got up near the 35 or the 25.
Colonial,
but it does
down.
Not matter either way. They got a first down right away.
Colonials take over first and 10. Ball on the Panther 28-yard line.
They're getting pretty deep into Cheltenham's territory right now. This could be an opening scoring drive for them, which would be great.
Yep. Handoff given to number 44, Nate. Six 6 for the Colonials.
Kern will gain 4 yards on the running play there, so they're on the 24-yard line for Cheltenham.
24-yard line.
Second and 6, here's the play. O'Brien gets taken down a little bit closer, about the 27, 28.
Number 3, Zion East. Loss of 1.
I believe that was Zion East, excuse me, who took the ball there, but it's a loss of 1 yard, so there'll be 7 yards to go for a first down. They're on the 25-yard line in Cheltenham's territory.
Ball on the Cheltenham 26-yard line.
And I think the best thing is, even if you don't get a first down, you might still be able to make the field goal from here, and 3 points is better than no points. You don't want to waste a drive here, especially against a team that's been red hot offensively. They're going for a passing play. Nice catch there, and he dropped it. Wow.
O'Brien pass,
tough play.
That'll now bring up
wide open, but he just dropped it. Nothing you can do about that one. On the 26-yard line, and we'll see if they go for a field goal here. And looks like they're just going to go for it here. Fourth down. See what the move is.
Timeout, Colonials.
And the Colonials will call a timeout here to talk over their game plan right now.
First timeout.
So they started off this game with a great running play, got up and deep into Cheltenham's territory. They got around the 40-yard line, and they were able to get first down on that first place after the kickoff, but Cheltenham was able to stop them from getting too far. So we'll see if they go for the field goal or not. I imagine that's what they'll do. I imagine they might not want to risk trying to go for that fourth down conversion, because what happens if you miss it? You turn over on downs. And look, they're not too close to their own territory, so it's not the end of the world
ladies
if they turn it down
Brian
here. Getting ready to resume play here as PW breaks from their timeout. And we'll see what the move is here. It looks like they're just going to go for it. And they will. And that play was unsuccessful there.
Number 2, Chris McLaughlin, is not good enough for the Colonial first down. The Panthers will take over.
So
first
now the Panthers
10.
Will be taking over.
Panther ball.
And it is in their own territory here on the 27-yard line. So they still have a ways to go. PW just needs to make sure they stop them from getting too close. And this will be Cheltenham's first possession of the game as they'll look to set a good example for the rest of the game.
Whoa.
Ooh. And the Colonial defense is able to get on them quickly. That'll be a loss of yards.
That's number 48, Jared Colson, on the tackle for a loss. That's a loss of 5 yards. That'll bring up second down.
A loss of 5 yards. That is huge for PW, as now Cheltenham has a bigger obstacle to climb.
Oh.
And there's a flag on the field. Took to the referee and see what it was.
77, Brian Cherry is the starter.
I believe that was on Colonial. And that one was on the Panthers.
That'll be a loss of 5 yards.
And there was another 5 yards, so they keep getting pushed down on the field. Second down and 20 now.
20 yards to go for the first down.
They're making it harder on themselves. This is not something you can do against the Colonials right now. They are already playing with a ton of steam, even with the off day. This is a solid team, a well-put-together team. They're a very cohesive unit. Any mistakes you make against them, they could easily capitalize on, whether it's preventing you from scoring, or whether it's keeping you, or whether it's them scoring themselves, as there's an incomplete pass on Sheltenham.
Pass ball's incomplete. There is a penalty on the play.
And there will be a penalty on the play. Let's see what's on. This might be on the Colonials this time.
An illegal receiver downfield
on Cheltenham, I think that is. As they just keep being pushed down the field. Yep, that one's on the Panthers. They just keep pushing themselves down the field. But PW will decline it. So third and 20, that's where they'll leave it here.
Ball on the Panther, 18-yard line.
Panthers need a miracle pass right now, or a miracle run. They've got to get 20 points. They've got to get up to the 38-yard line at least to get a first down here. It's going to be tough, but anything can happen. A great pass, a great run. You get by some defenders, and all of a sudden you could be breaking midfield and seeing nothing but daylight, or I guess open field. It's not really daylight. There's a pass complete. He'll go out of bounds there. And I do not believe
Zaire
that is enough
Williams.
For the first down.
That's number three, Zaire Williams on the reception for the Panthers.
Zaire Williams for the Panthers makes that catch. It's a gain of 10, but it is not enough to get the first down here. They might just stick with the punt here at 4th and 10. It's probably the best move here, but...
Number three, Zion East, back deep to receive.
Zion East is ready to receive the punt from Cheltenham. And here's the play, here's the punt. And East will let it roll. And they'll let it stop here. That one will be deep in PW's territory. And that is on the 25-yard line.
The
Colonial territory.
First and 10, Colonial.
So, the big thing for Colonial now is they're not as close as you were in your first possession, right? But the big thing is just get some nice running gains here, nice passing gains. Make your way up the field slowly. You don't need big passes. You don't need grand throws, grand runs. As long as you're getting those first downs, as long as you're working your way down the field. And if you can let the clock run out a bit, you might give Cheltenham less time to strike, even if you don't score. So, big thing is just keeping the ball in your possession as long as possible. And here's the play. And looks like they'll try a running play.
That's quarterback Aiden O'Brien on the carry. Short gain.
Aiden O'Brien will make a small gain here. What looks to be two or three yards.
A gain of one yard.
So they'll be at second at 9 on their 26-yard line. And here's the play again. Chris McLaughlin tries the running play here, but does not work for them.
Gain of 4.
Gain
4. For the Colonials.
So third and 5 on their 30-yard line. Might go for a passing play here. Try to gain those 5 yards easily if they can find an open man. There you go. Here's the play. Aiden O'Brien will try to run it up
O'Brien
the field.
On the keeper, short of the first down.
But they will not get the first down here.
That'll bring up 4th down and 2
and
for the Colonials.
We'll see if they try to set up the punt. Looks like there's a player on the field who is injured right now on the Cheltenham Panthers. So I took a quick break here. And in the meantime, we'll talk about Spirit Week. It's been Spirit Week in PW. We've had a lot of great dress-up days during the day, and we've had a lot of great events after school. On Monday after school, there was the Wing Bowl. On Wednesday, there was Color Wars. Yesterday, there was Powder Puff. Today, of course, is the homecoming football game. And then tomorrow will be the homecoming dance. And Tuesday there were no events. It was just a rest day. Or let everyone get their work in. You know, get a little extra sleep in if you need to. I can tell you it's been a bit of a tiring week, but it's been a fun week at that. Very excited to go to the dance tomorrow. Hopefully you'll be there too. As Panther will walk off the field under his own weight. And we'll hope he's all right. And play will be resuming here again.
Jamal Banks.
As that was Jamal Banks
back
on Shelton.
The Panthers, number five, Jamal Banks.
Or Jamal Banks is coming in for the injured player on Shelton Ham. Excuse me. And it looks like they're going for a punting play.
Punting for the Colonials. Nick Scanapico.
Nick Scanapico will be punting. And here's the kick.
Nice punt.
That's a great punt. It's going to go deep, and it's going to bounce away. And it's going to bounce well into Shelton Ham territory. Right around the 7-8-yard line.
Beautiful punt there by
this is
going to
make things
Scanapico
very, very difficult for for Cheltenham. They've got a lot of field to cover.
First and 10.
First
ball
and 10 here. It is on their
7-yard
line. And again, this is a very, very tough thing to come back for Cheltenham. You've got to go all the way up past your field about 40-some yards and then 50-some yards down to the touchdown. To the end zone, excuse me. But anything can happen here. Great pass, a great run. Find some open ground, and who knows? This very play could end up being a running play that covers the whole field.
That'll be a timeout, Cheltenham.
Cheltenham will call a timeout here.
Timeout.
So both teams have called at least one timeout now.
6 minutes and 26 seconds remain.
6:26 to go in the first quarter. No score right now.
No score between the Panthers of Cheltenham and your Colonials.
Well, I highlighted this game before the game as what could be a very strong offensive game, and we have seen some solid offense today,
we'll
but it's been a great defensive game instead so far. But we are very early on right now. Anything can happen. As there's a cheerleading act going on right now, as well as the marching band playing. And I think they just promoted the PW snack bar down here at PW Field. Don't go to the snack bar too late, though. If you're ever going to a football game, don't wait too long. You're not going to find much there. I made that unfortunate mistake a little bit ago. A couple weeks ago, I think it was, at one of the games. But, you know what, I learned my lesson. I'll keep it in mind for future games I'm at. And play is about to resume again. And here we go. It's a handoff here.
Seven.
A great tackle there, and it'll keep Cheltenham from advancing very far. I think he might have lost a yard there, possibly.
Cheltenham run taken down by number 7, Taji Hubbard.
It was Taji Hubbard who took him down there.
That'll be a loss of 2 on the play. Bring the ball back.
They're now
to
on their
Panther, 5-yard
line.
5-yard line.
Cheltenham is now on their own 5-yard line. They gotta be careful here. Of course, if you get tackled in your own end zone, it's a safety and it's 2 points for the opposing team, so. They're going to do everything they can to prevent it. You might not see a lot of passing plays in case PW gets close enough to take him down in their own end zone. Cheltenham will break out for a little bit of light there. So they did not get too far, but they get a little farther away from their own end zone, which is big.
Tackle made by number 46, Joey Foy. Gain of 3. It'll bring up a 3rd down and 9.
3rd and 9 for Cheltenham right now on their 8-yard line.
Ball on the Panther.
That
kind of
course by
line.
Joey Foy. We'll see what the move is here. And they're going to go for a passing play here. Oh, he's going to try to run away now. And he held on to the ball instead and tried to make a run, but he was not able to get far enough. Shelton Hamm will be going for the punt as Joey Troilo made that tackle there. Yes, Shelton Hamm will be going for the punt there.
No gain on the play. It'll bring up a fourth down.
Looks like Zion East again is back out there to recover the punt.
Back deep for the Colonials. Number three, Zion East.
And here it comes from Shelton Hamm. Oh, that's a great punt there. East makes the recovery, but he'll be taken down right around the 45-yard line. As Oakdale East was trying to go back a little bit and find some open ground to run forward on. But he went back a little too far right into the arms of the defender of Shelton Hamm. This will be exactly on the 45-yard line here.
First and 10,
so they don't have too far to go, but about 55 yards to their own end zone. Again, the big goal here is just keep possession of the ball as long as you can, because even if you don't score, it's less time for Shelton Hamm to get the ball. And here's the first play of the possession here. It's a running play. They're able to find a little bit of light, but it's right into Shelton Hamm defenders.
That's number 44, Nate Kern on the carry.
Nate Kern there with the running play. He will gain about
second down and nine for
gain
the
1 yard.
Ball
as they're on their 46-yard line now. Second and nine. Right now, 3 minutes and 40 seconds to go in the first quarter. No score right as of now. BW look to change that here.
Zion East.
As East will get the ball. And that's a great running play.
That's Zion East on the carry.
He'll get
good
it back
enough
into Shelton Hamm's territory.
Colonial.
It's a first down for Colonial. As it looks like it's on to Shelton Hamm 40. A great run there by
Zion,
Zion East.
Play.
Now that they're back on Shelton Hamm's territory, about keeping the pressure on them. Keeping the pressure on that defense.
Holding.
And it looks like there's a penalty on PW there, a holding penalty. And this will set them back. And they'll be right back to where they started. That's unfortunate for them. They'll go back 10 yards.
Replay second down.
Second down now.
Ball be placed
on the
Colonial
35-yard
line.
That's a huge penalty for Shelton Hamm as it stops them from progressing any further.
Second and 18
now. Need a big pass. It looks like that's what they're going for. They find an open receiver. He takes the ball away. And he will get just a little past the 45-yard line. As that was recovered by Chris McLaughlin there. It's a good pass.
Picking up to the Colonial 46-yard line. We'll bring up third down and nine for the Colonials.
Third and nine now for the Colonials. And here we go with the third and nine play. And they're going to go for a pass. It looks like this is a deep pass. And it's intercepted by Shelton Hamm. And they'll make a deep run down the field into PW territory, and it's fumbled. And I think PW
ball
is able to recover
the
fumble.
Panthers, then fumbled and recovered by the Colonials.
As the Colonials did a huge break there. The ball is there once again.
The Colonials will maintain possession. First
and it'll
and
reset
10.
Downs again at first and 10.
Colonials. Ball will be placed on the Colonial 33-yard line.
So around the Colonial 33-yard line as they just prevented something huge from happening for Shelton Hamm. That'll be a big sigh of relief now. So under, a little under 2.5 minutes to go here. And they'll try a running play here. Looks like they're able to break free for pretty decent gain there. As that was Aiden O'Brien on the run.
That's good for 7 yards.
A 7 yard gain here. As it's second and three on their 40-yard line. They're looking to continue their progress on the field. Here's a deep pass. And this one is incomplete.
O'Brien pass was
they went for
incomplete.
A big play there, but unfortunately fell short for PW.
That'll bring up third down and three for the
So
Colonials.
Third and three here. Still don't have
Ball
that far to go to
line.
Get a first down here. So you don't need to necessarily go for a deep pass like that again. I think the big thing is just getting those 3 yards any way you can. A running play, a passing play. Right now we have 1 minute 50 to go here in the first quarter with no score on either side. And here's the play.
That's Nate Kern on the
Nate
carry.
Kern tried to go for the carry
Looks
there.
To be good enough.
And that one will be a first
Colonial
down.
First down.
So we'll reset back to first and 10 again. The ball looks to be on the 44-yard line.
44-yard line.
Colonial's 44-yard line, that is.
That'll be a timeout.
There's a timeout called by
Cheltenham.
They've called their second timeout today.
1 minute, 30 seconds remain. First quarter.
As right now,
no
1.5 minutes left in the first quarter. Again, no
the
score. It's been a solid defensive game so far. But both teams have hurt themselves a little bit. Of course, we had that PW interception that Cheltenham went back and fumbled again. And then, of course, we had Cheltenham have a couple penalties in the earlier possession. In their last one, I believe it was. Got themselves very close to their own end zone, which could have been very dangerous for them. But they're fortunate enough to prevent the safety from happening. They're able to just punt it back. And that's where we stand right now. Still looks like there's a few students streaming in here. And I'm telling you, these football games have been a huge crowd, and I think everyone's missed that in a way. Of course, last year with the pandemic year, it was reserved to just, we have two family members per team. I believe, if my memory serves me correct, it was two family members for each marching band member as well. But no away fans were allowed either. Now, right now, it doesn't look like there's too many people in the away stands. That's usually how it goes, though. The student section is up. It's right in the middle of the stands. It is the marching band Colonials. As we speak, there's a great pass and play.
Pass
still making a big gain there.
Jared Colson makes the flag on the play.
Jared Colson makes the reception there, but there's a flag. We'll see who that's on.
That's an illegal shift on the Colonials.
An illegal
five
shift on
penalty.
The Colonials. A 5 yard penalty, so we'll take him back a little bit.
Replay first down. We'll bring up
first
down. First
and
15
now. Let's move back to the 38 yard line.
Ball on the Colonial.
39 yard line. Still first down, so they've got a couple plays to work with to try to make something happen before they get the fourth down. And they're going to go to a running play here. And they're passing it now. There's a deep pass, and they make the catch. A fantastic catch as they were deep into Cheltenham territory. An incredible pass from the halfback. That was Phil Terramina that made the catch. Phil Terramina, that is.
That's good enough for a Colonial first down.
First down in Cheltenham territory now with 1:14 left to go in the first quarter. A huge play there. This is in Cheltenham 18-yard line. It's going to be field goal territory, even if they can't make the touchdown there. Is that play? There's a running play with McLaughlin there, but he'll be taken down. And it looks like a decent takedown from Shelton Ham there. It looks like they PW lost about 3 or 4 yards. We'll get the official ruling in a second.
Loss of 6 on the play. Now
loss
we have second
six.
Down and 16 for the Colonials. Well, just
second
inside
and 16.
The Panther 25-yard line.
Was just inside the 25-yard line. Still plenty of room to make some noise for PW before the half ends. And they're going to go with a passing play here, but this one lands in no man's land.
Pass overthrown by number 4, Aiden O'Brien.
It is Aiden O'Brien on the pass.
That'll bring up third down and 16.
Third and 16, still just inside the 25-yard line. So
again, ball just inside the Colonial 25, excuse me, the Panther 25-yard line.
I think the best thing that could happen right now for the Colonials is to just get the ball down a little bit farther. If they can't get the first down, then maybe they can go for the field goal here, and I imagine that's what they'll do, as long as they don't get set back too far on this drive. There's the play. They're going to go for a pass again from Aiden O'Brien. They make the catch, but they knock the receiver
O'Brien
down.
Pass complete to number 3, Zion East.
So Zion East on the reception there. And with just under 10 seconds, so it looks like they might just let the clock run out.
That's going to bring up fourth down.
And yes, that'll end the first quarter here. So at the end of the first quarter, no score. Although when we come up to start the second
quarter,
it looks like the Colonials may have a prime chance to score here.
No score.
As I imagine, they'll just want to go for the field goal right now.
Put a point Mars Colonials.
So as we're getting ready to begin the second quarter, in about a minute or two, I imagine. Some notes from this game is that both teams have seemed to hurt themselves with penalties. We saw it in one of the earlier Cheltenham drives where they got very close to their own end zone. And we saw it a little bit in this drive from PW. They pushed themselves back a little bit, 5 yards, 10 yards. Both teams have been hurt by penalties that they want to try to avoid. Both teams are moving down the field a bit. I believe the fields will be reversed.
Sevae
Sproul will be coming in for the field goal here. Sevae is a junior on the team. A 32-yard attempt. I wish him the best of luck here. This will be the first points of the game. Be nice for Cheltenham to get that good start. Nice for PW to get that good start and be the first team to score. Break the ice here. So both teams are getting set. And there's the whistle. And it looks like the play's about to begin. Let's see what happens. PW hoping for the best here. 32-yard attempt, and it is no good. As it goes wide left of the goalpost. So no score there for PW. As now Cheltenham will try to take the ball back down the field on the punt, or on the kick. I believe.
First and 10 Panthers.
No, don't just take the ball from where PW left it. So it's first and 10 here.
Ball will be placed on the Panthers.
It's on the Panthers' 20-yard line. They've got about 80 yards to go for a touchdown here. We've seen some pretty good passes from PW. We'll see if Cheltenham can emulate the same thing. And is that a flag on the field? Might have been.
Was it penalty?
Yep.
It's a penalty on
back.
The field.
The penalty's on the Panthers.
That one is on the Panthers.
5-yard penalty.
A 5-yard penalty as they're pushing them back to their 15-yard line.
What's
Braun, and Shelton Hamm has found daylight. And there is nothing but open ground to run to. An 85-yard run for Shelton Hamm. And that's a big morale-boosting touchdown.
To Zaim Welton on the 85-yard touchdown run for the Panthers.
As of now, it's 6-0. As with the extra point, it'll make it 7-0. If they go for a 2-point conversion, make it 8-0. But it looks like they're just going to go for the field goal here, or for the extra point. Couldn't hurt. And here we go with the extra point. And it is.
Panther point after attempt.
It is good, as it will make it on the left side of the goalposts there. 7-0.
With 11:43 remaining.
With 11:43 to go in the second quarter here. As now the Colonials look to answer back here. Maybe this will be the start of an offensive showdown here that we hinted at earlier today. Again, both teams had red hot offenses coming into this game. It might have just taken them about a quarter or two to get running. It might have taken them about a quarter to get running, but we'll see what happens. As Shelton Hamm looks like they'll be getting ready for kickoff.
Number two,
looks like they have Devin Orensky down there and Chris McLaughlin ready to receive the ball.
Devin Orensky, back deep for the Colonials.
Shelton Hamm gets himself in position. And here's the kickoff. This one will be received by McLaughlin. And that ball went to Orensky there. So they again did that pass off.
Reverse given to number 19,
as McLaughlin
Orensky
caught the ball. But he gave it to Orensky as a pass.
We're
up to the 28-yard line on the Colonial side. First and 10. As they'll look to start their answer back. Or a field goal. And here's the play. He'll go for a run, but he'll be taken down.
Number two, Chris McLaughlin.
That was Chris McLaughlin there.
On the carry. That's a loss on the play.
And they'll lose a couple yards
loss
there.
Loss of three.
Loss of 3 yards. Second and down. Second down, 13.
Ball in the Colonial 25-yard line.
25-yard line. Let's see how they advance.
We saw it a lot on this, but we also showed up on here.
Here's the play. And it does not look like they'll make it too far down.
That's number three, Zion East.
Zion East there on the carry.
On the carry. Gain of three.
And they'll gain back to his yards they just lost. So they're back to third and 10 on their 28-yard line.
On the Colonial 28-yard line.
Colonial's looking for a big play here with third and 10. And they'll look for the pass. There's a deep pass to an open receiver. He dives. Did he catch it?
Pass to number 20, Phil Taramina, falls short.
And they'll say it landed before he caught it. So an incomplete pass. That one was to Phil Taramina.
Ball on the Colonial 28-yard line.
So it's ball on the 28-yard line. I believe they'll just punt it down to Cheltenham.
Number 3, Zaire Williams. And number 5, Jamal Banks, back deep for the Panthers.
Zaire Williams and Jamal Banks will be receiving for the Panthers here. That punt is a little shallow, and it'll bounce into bounce out of bounds. It'll be about at the 47-yard line in Cheltenham territory. 47, 48-yard line.
In Panther territory, where the Panthers will take over first and 10.
First and 10, not too far down for the Panthers to go down, as that one was on their 48-yard line. Not too far for the Panthers to go down. They'd love to add to this in any fashion here, whether it be another 7 points, 8 points with a two-point conversion after the touchdown, or just a field goal. 7-0 here, with just a little over 10 minutes to go in the second period, in the second quarter, that is. And here's the play. They'll take him down pretty quickly. Looks like that was a loss of about 3 yards.
That tackle made by number 65. Louis
Malacara.
That is a tackle for a loss.
Tackle was made.
That'll bring up second down and 13 for the Panthers. Ball in the Panther.
Luis Malfaro was the one who made the tackle, as they're now down to their 45-yard line, Cheltenham is. Second down, still enough time to make a big pass or a big run here. That could at least cut into how much they need for a first down. As they'll go with the passing play on the side there, but they take him down.
That was number four. That's Aiden O'Brien.
As that was Aiden O'Brien on the tackle there, as they bring Cheltenham back a little more.
Four, Aiden O'Brien. Another play for a loss.
That one looks to be a loss of about 4 yards.
That
was on their 41-yard line.
For the Panthers.
Third and 18
ball
for the Panthers.
Panther, 41-yard line.
Just a 1-1 to 9 minutes to go, as you can see there. Got a 7-0 score. Cheltenham now just trying to advance on the field. And that'll be a timeout on Cheltenham, as they've used their last timeout here in this half. 8:34 to go in the second quarter. We'll see what the move is here. As you can see, the crowd, there is a ton of people, as mentioned earlier, who showed up today. They've been a very loud crowd when PW has the ball. The marching band is playing. The cheerleaders are doing a routine here. Both teams will return to the field now. And we're back on the field. Cheltenham is here with a 3rd and 18. Alright, so welcome back. We had some technical difficulties here with our camera. He's back with the ball again. And the The Colonials are on their own territory here.
Line,
their 34-yard line. 33-yard line.
The Colonials will take over.
First and 10, they'll
first
work to make some progress down the field.
Colonials.
And I'm sure they'd love to strike back here. They have not scored yet. It's 7-0 Cheltenham. We'll have to put a little bit of pressure, make them think a little bit with even a field goal. Of course, I'm sure you want the touchdown. That's always the end goal of every drive. But putting pressure on them, making them think in any way possible by scoring is the biggest key here. Still, it's not like there's time running out here with a little over 7.5 minutes to go in the second quarter. And here's the play. And look to get a carry from Nate Kern.
Oh, no.
No, it wasn't. 36.
Never mind, that was number 36 with the carry.
Correction, number 36, Greg Feinberg on the
Gregory
carry.
Feinberg with the carry. Gained 5 yards. It'll bring up to the 39-yard line. Here's the play again. This one looks to be another carry. That was a good one. That was
Greg Feinberg,
Greg Feinberg again. I believe that is enough for a
That's
first
good
down.
For a Colonial
yes, it
first
is.
Down.
This one is about the 49-yard line, the 48-yard line, Colonial territory. Go with another carry here.
That's number 36. For the third straight
Gregory
carry.
Feinberg again on the carry.
Good for 3 yards.
We'll gain 3 yards there.
Second down and seven.
Second and
for the
seven
Colonials.
On the 51-yard
Ball
line.
Colonial, 47-yard line.
There's the play. It's another carry. And this one, they're running down the field. And they will be taken down deep in Cheltenham territory. Aiden O'Brien with a long carry down the field, but there's a flag on the field. It looks like there's a player down around midfield too on Cheltenham's side. I believe we have another injured player. Well, if it's not a penalty on PW, they just made their way down the field. It's a huge gain, but the biggest concern here is the player on the field. Let's hope he's okay right now. He'll walk off the field here under his own weight. And we'll hope that that player is all right for Cheltenham. As now I believe the referees are discussing the penalty on the field. We'll get the official ruling in just a bit here. Those are boos from the crowd. I believe that one is on PW.
Shot block, Colonials.
Yep, that's a penalty on Colonial, a personal foul.
Penalties will offset. They will replay second down.
Penalty on both the Colonials and the Panthers. And it completely resets that play. The first time as if it doesn't even happen at all. So we're back to second and seven here. 6:15 to go in the second quarter. 7-0's our score. So they will resume play here. Right there on the 47-yard line, PW territory. And here's the snap. O'Brien passes this one off quickly. There's a big gain. He's going down the field. Chris McLaughlin will make his way all the way down near the 20-yard line. A big carry from Chris McLaughlin as the PW Colonials work their way deep into Cheltenham territory. A huge, huge run. As now they have set themselves back up again in a big scoring opportunity. They are down on the 17-yard line in Panthers territory. First and 10. The crowd got alive there when that happened. Speaking of the crowd, you can see some more people coming in.
Yeah.
The people just don't stop coming by. Some people down by the gates as well.
Greg Feinberg on the carry.
Of course, can't be on the track unless you're with the team, with the cheerleaders, with staff, or with CITV.
It's good for 5 yards, and you're out second down and 5 for the Colonials.
A second and 5, there's a 5-yard carry there. So they'll be up on the 12-yard line in Cheltenham territory.
Panther 11-yard line.
Panther 11-yard line. And here's the play again.
That's number 4, Aiden O'Brien on the keeper.
Aiden O'Brien make the carry. We'll not get too far.
Short of first down. Bring up third down and 1.
Third and 1 now.
Ball on the Panthers, 8-yard line.
Ball on the Panthers, 8-yard line. They need just 1 yard for the first down. For the first down. We'll see if that was enough. Feinberg on the run.
Number 36, Greg Feinberg on
yep,
the carry.
That was Gregory Feinberg with the carry, and it's
first
a Colonial
down.
First down. First and goal now. As they're at the 5-yard line. Here we go with the play. It's a running play from Aiden O'Brien, and it is good for a touchdown. T.W. scores here. Touchdown for a touchdown. They make it 7-6. With an extra point, it'll tie up the game. With a 2-point conversion, they'll take the lead. But that touchdown was big. As Cheltenham now has to think again. And we're going for the extra point here. This one is good.
Savase Brawl
with the extra point there to make it 7-all. As we have 4:39 to go here in the second quarter. And that's a big, big game for the Colonials. Add some morale back.
Your score.
That's a little bit of momentum, too.
Panthers 7-7.
Started. It's a brand new ball game. W will be going for the kickoff now. Cheltenham will look to answer back on the touchdown there with a big drive of their own. Here we go. Here's the kickoff to Cheltenham. Down the field goes. A great kick. They'll cover it inside the 20. Now they'll try to bring it up a little bit more. But there's the defender right on that receiver. Zaire Williams was the one who received the ball. And it looks like there's a flag on the field. There's been a ton of flags already in just these first two quarters alone. Waiting for the official ruling here. Tell if that one was on Cheltenham or the Colonials. I don't think it was on Cheltenham. Move down the field a little more. Yep, that's an illegal block on the Panthers. I think. Gotta be careful of the safety here. Play. That was a running game, it looks like. Thomas Montemayor was on the tackle there. As Cheltenham to have gained a few yards.
I mean, a tackle for a loss.
No, they lost yards.
Second down and 11.
Second and 11 on their own 8-yard line.
The Panthers.
Have to be careful, of course, still have the safety. Second and 11, they went with the carry again, but does not look like they have gained much, if anything, on that play. EW's defense has been fantastic here. Tommy Hannon was the one on that tackle.
Number 40, Kevin Hegarty on the tackle. No gain. That'll bring up
no gain,
third
so
down and 11.
They'll stay on the 8. Panthers will stay on their own 8-yard line as third and 11. Seven score here. Here's the play. It's a pass, and it is intercepted by Plymouth White Marsh. As they'll take it down the field, and that'll be a touchdown.
That's a pick six.
A pick six there.
Seven.
Najee Hubbard with a pick six, and the Colonials strike again with another touchdown. They make it 13-7 here. As the crowd is alive again. And there's nothing better than the crowd alive, the marching band playing, the cheerleaders going. It's a sign that things are going well in the stadium tonight. Fantastic interception there by Najee Hubbard and a great run to keep it going down the field, avoiding the defenders and bringing it into their own end zone for a touchdown. The mood on the PW sideline is one of great joy. Sebae Spruill with the extra point makes it 14-7 with a little under 3 minutes to go. 14-7 now. Cheltenham looking for an answer again.
Your Colonials 14, Panthers 7.
14-7 game. Both teams talking out on the sides. And how about that play there from Najee Hubbard? Great catch. He was in the right place, right time. We could spend forever talking about the pick six there, but keep a long story short. Great play. PW scores. We're all happy here. 14-7. As both teams are back on the field, PW is ready to kick the ball off again. Here's the kickoff from PW. This one's a short one as they tried to, assuming they tried to recover their
kick
there, but it did not work out. Panthers will get it on their 40-yard line. They'll try to progress up the field.
Panthers will take over.
Ball on the 41-yard line for the Panthers. We'll take this a little bit of a break here to remind you, if you are planning on going to the homecoming dance, it's $20 at the door. I believe they moved into the cafeteria due to rain concerns tomorrow. 7 to 9:30, I believe, are the times. Come out with your costumes. Hopefully it'll be a great time. Here's the play. They'll go for a pass here, and that one will be incomplete as that one misses the receiver. Ball is set on the 41-yard line now. Second and 10. For a passing play here. Oh no, they got it. We'll try to make an emergency pass, and they do. But it won't get them much farther than they were before. I think that was a loss of yards there.
Rushed by number 48, Jared Colson. Play taken down by Dix Canapico. No gain on the play.
No gain there.
We're on third down and 10.
Third and 10, Cheltenham again stays on their own 41-yard line. Looking for another miracle play to hopefully get a first down here and continue their possession in the ball. They need something big here. As they got a little over 2 minutes to go right now. 14-7, PW leads. Here's the play. Looks like a running play. Able to work back up the field quite a bit. That should be good for a first down for Cheltenham. As they got exactly what they needed there.
That's number one, Camden Wyatt on the reception. Good enough
Camden
for
Wyatt
first
with
down.
The reception
Take
there.
Good enough for 9 yards.
Number 7. It wasn't Kazi Yoder.
score.
Broncos 14, Panthers 13, 36 seconds remain in the second quarter.
Right now, a little over 30 seconds to go here, as it's 14-13, PW has the lead. Cheltenham got a touchdown but missed the extra point. We're still having some technical issues right now.
Festivities.
right now we've had, or we're going on right now, if you just tuned in or if you stay tuned in, we have the homecoming court candidates coming out right now. It's the first time we've gotten to do this since 2019. Of course, last year was a pandemic, we couldn't. So it's a very exciting time for everybody. It's a very exciting time for all the candidates. As we will try to give you the candidates' names as they come out. I believe it's a total of four or five people who will come out. A king and a queen. And here's what looks to be our last candidates, Danielle Kabibo, I believe it is, and Brian Schetter. If I butchered your last name and you are catching this at any point later, I severely apologize. But looks like there might be one more group out there. Cannot really tell from here, but one more group coming down. So it'll be a total of five groups here who will be, their classmates have voted on who should win for homecoming court, king and queen. We'll see which one wins. I'm sure you can imagine it's a very exciting time for all of them right now. It's very difficult to imagine what's going through their heads right now. A lot of excitement here being celebrated among their fellow peers.
Thank you.
50-50 tickets. You bought a blue 50-50 ticket. Winner will receive $219. And your numbers are 967-27-32. 967-27-32. You know you always will receive service with a smile.
Got the smile. 50-50, that would be me.
That would be you.
I just need to see those numbers.
Tyler! Nah.
Thank you.
how should we? First of all, do you know? Alright, everybody, and welcome back to the PWHS Stadium. As we are getting ready to begin the second half, right now we are at a 14-13 game. We've had a great game today. A lot of back and forth action from both Cheltenham and PW. We've had a couple of technical issues, some of you may have noticed it. So we apologize for any of the issues that have come up. Of course, we are trying to sort things out as best we can. But for now, our main focus is just bringing you a good broadcast. And hopefully we'll be able to do so in the second half as well. Here come the PW players back on the field. To begin in a little over 2.5 minutes. You see the PW players circled up together. They seem they're probably doing some stretching. Yep. So far what you have missed is the homecoming court. We had the voting for that just a bit ago. And if we do pick up the names of the winners at any point, I will go over them, of course. But otherwise, not too much else has been missed right now. 14-13. We've had a good game. It's been everything we've hoped for. There's a very, very packed stadium. And for the viewers watching at home, thank you for tuning in. If you weren't able to make this game, maybe you'll be able to make the next one. It's all right. It happens. Just a little over a minute and a half to go until play resumes again. So, if you're looking for other talking points right now, as we wait for the game to begin, you have an interest in baseball right now. Here's your quick look at all of the postseason scores right now. Rays lead the Red Sox 5-4. Astros beat the White Sox 9-4. And the Brewers beat the Braves 2-1. Giants and Dodgers are yet to play. We have a little over a minute to go. As the BW team gets together real quick to talk things out. Get a little hype before the second half. There's some players on the Cheltenham side talking things out as well. As we've seen a competitive match, but we've also seen a fair share of mistakes on both sides. We've also seen a ton of penalties, not just from PW, from Cheltenham as well. So I tell a lot of lost yards, a lot of lost opportunities. And it's something that both teams desperately need to patch out as we begin the second half. And we've just got the names for the homecoming king and queen. So the homecoming king was Joe Redman. And I believe Amy DeSisto was the homecoming queen. So congrats to both of them. And we are ready to begin the second half. Just about. Yes, the Cheltenham Panthers will receive the ball. So PW will get ready to kick it off. From the vantage point that you guys are seeing, Cheltenham is going down to the left side here to start off the third quarter. And going down the right quarter will be PW.
Number 5, Jamal Banks.
PW heads out to the field, getting ready for the kickoff. Here we go. And with this coming kick, the second half will begin. As that one is caught just in front of the 30-yard line, and PW will jump on that receiver quickly. They'll push him back a little bit farther. And he'll end up on Cheltenham's side at about roughly the 28-yard line in Panthers territory.
Ball will be down on the Panther 32-yard line.
It's the 32-yard line.
Panthers will take over and start the second half.
And right now there's a balloon floating by the press box, and off it goes. A lot of things to see here. Cheltenham will get things ready. First and 10 on their own 32. We got a touchdown before the second quarter ended. Look to carry some of that momentum now into the third quarter. They go with their passing play here. And they'll move up a few yards.
That's number 34, Tommy Hannon on the stop.
It's Tommy Hannon with the stopper. Panthers will gain.
I'll bring up second down and eight.
Panthers will gain 2 yards now. They got second and eight on their territory.
34-yard line.
And here's the play. They're going for another running game again. PW will jump on him quickly, however. Doesn't look like they gained.
Host of Colonials.
Look like they might have lost the yard, actually.
No gain. That'll bring up third down.
So it'll gain a third down here on the 34-yard line. Cheltenham looking for a big gain here to get that first down and continue their possession. And here we go. It's a passing play. The throw is good. And it will be stopped. Is that a first down? We will find out, but it was a complete
pass. Panthers screen pass brought down by number 3, Zion East.
Zion East was the one who took down
the
receiver.
That's going to bring up fourth down and two.
Fourth and two.
For the Panthers.
Panthers just come short of the first down on their 40-yard line. But this close to first down, they might just go for it here. Fourth and two, looks like they're going to go for it. And yes, they will with the running play, but PW stops them quickly.
Fourth down attempt by the Panthers.
And that fourth down conversion will be no good. PW will get the ball back now on their. PW will take over now in Cheltenham territory. They tried to go for it not too far away from the first down, but PW was able to stop them very quickly. First and 10, Cheltenham territory.
Ball on the Panther.
Ball on the 37-yard line. And here's the play. They're going to go hand them off here. And they'll break away for a pretty sizable gain. Gregory Feinberg there. So ran an outside route.
That run's good for 8 yards. It'll bring up second down.
8 yards, so second and two now for the Colonials as they inch ever closer now. They'd love to start the second quarter, the third quarter here with a touchdown.
Again, that's number 36, Greg Feinberg.
Another carry there from Greg Feinberg.
On the play.
This time it does not look like
that'll be a loss of two. That'll bring out third down and four for the Colonials.
Lost 2 yards, so it's third and four now.
Ball on the Panther, 31-yard line.
Ball is in the Panthers' 31-yard line. And there's a flag on the field.
Flag on play.
I believe this one might be on Shelton. Yeah. And a second flag just went on the field. Wow. Still waiting on what happened in the first flag, but that second flag then came up while they were discussing it.
Five-yard penalty
on the Panthers, but unsportsmanlike conduct on the Colonials helped counteract that. Penalties have been a big story this game. As we mentioned, just around the start of the second half, penalties have been big on both sides. Both teams have received a ton of them, and it's something that they need to cut down on big time. With both penalties, it'll just negate the last play that happened. Something's still being discussed among the refs right now. Both teams are waiting for other directions. Right now, we have a little over 9 minutes at a 14-13 game right now. Clock is going now. Coming back down. And yeah, I guess the play resets here.
Appears to be third down and 14 for the Colonials.
Nope, it's third and 14 on the Colonials. They're They go all wild, they snap it, and this one clears who they were trying to snap it to. PW was able to recover it.
And recovered by the Colonials.
So we'll now make it fourth down. PW recovered that one on the 48-yard line.
Fourth down. And 23 yards.
Fourth and
23.
And it looks like he'll be going for the punt. Of course, that's the most logical option here. A couple of people back down the field there. Cheltenham. Here's the punt. It's a good one. Someone will bounce a little bit and allow it to roll. It's picked up by a player on Cheltenham, but a couple of defenders from PW are able to rush over there and stop him quickly. And it'll keep it relatively far down on Cheltenham's side.
15-yard line. First and 10
here. The team's getting formation. And this will start the possession here for Cheltenham. Here's the play. Go with a rushing play here. This one does not work out, however. Only getting a couple of yards. Clock continues ticking down here, about 7.5 minutes to go.
Gain of 3.
And obviously our gain.
I've never had Diet Coke before.
There's a pass from Cheltenham. It's good. The receiver finds it and finds a little bit of open ground. That should be a first down now. Cheltenham will escape deep within their own territory. They'll bring themselves back up.
Taken down by number 7, Taji Hubbard.
Taji Hubbard was the one to take
down
the receiver.
For a Panther first down.
First and 10 here, it's on the Panthers'
32-yard line.
Here's the play, they're going with the rushing play again. And it's lost in the cluster of defenders and players.
That Panther play, taken down. Number 46, Joey Foy.
Joey Foy took it down. They're going to play again here. Another rushing play. This one looks to work out a little bit better. Found a little more open ground.
Run, good enough for a first down.
And they'll get another first down here. And we have another injury delay, it looks like. Down goes another Cheltenham player. And hopefully he's all right. We'll cut away to the score here real quick. Under 6.5 minutes to go, 14-13 here in the third quarter. Both players huddle up here. Both teams huddle up here, excuse me. We've seen a couple other injuries earlier today on Cheltenham's side. And hopefully all three players are okay. Hopefully they will be able to recover quickly and get back on the field as soon as possible. So we wish them the best of health here. Some PW players walking over to Cheltenham's side, returning to the field. And then we're heading back to the sidelines. There goes PW. Out around the center of the field. And take a look at the crowd. Look at all that neon. Neon day today, if you couldn't tell. Hey, I'm telling you, you wouldn't miss any of the PW kids here in the dark, would you? The injured player will walk off the field. Looks to be able to get there under his own weight.
Number five, Jamal Banks for Cheltenham. Give a round of applause.
Jamal Banks is one exiting the field. A round of applause.
Panthers will have the ball first and 10.
Panthers have first and 10 here as play is beginning to resume. It's on the Panthers 43-yard line. They'll work to continue moving up the field. And here we go with another rushing play. Looks like he'll gain a few yards off that one. Here it's very tough to tell who's who. Looks like on the tackle there. Still determining the official ruling right now. A big crowd over
that
there.
That Panther play taken down by number 48, Jared Colson.
Jared Colson took down the Panther runner there. Players coming out of this game.
Ball in Colonial territory.
Third down, the ball is slowly encroaching into Colonial territory here. Going with a deep pass now, but this one will way overshoot the receiver.
Incomplete. That's going to bring up fourth and short.
Fourth and short now.
Ball on the Colonial.
On the Colonial 47-yard line. I think for Cheltenham,
fourth
they might just go for
less
it.
Than a yard.
They might as well. Fourth and inches here. Don't need too much. A short run, a short pass. Not much is needed here for the first down. And a flag goes on the field.
Flag on the play.
Been a lot of flags on the field today.
Encroachment.
This one will be on PW.
Encroachment. The Panthers a first down.
And the Panthers will be able to get a first down off
ball
of that.
Ball placed on the Colonial 41-yard line.
I tell you, for as good of a back and forth game this has been, this has also been a bit of an ugly game on both sides with the penalties. Both teams have been able to gain significant yards. Here's the pass from Cheltenham, and it is not picked off, but it is blocked. So it'll be an incomplete pass on Cheltenham there.
That pass deflected by number two, Chris McLaughlin.
Chris McLaughlin wants to run.
On the play.
And surprise, surprise, we have a flag on the play.
That's an ineligible receiver downfield.
An ineligible receiver downfield for the Panthers. Another penalty for the Panthers. Another penalty in this game.
That penalty is declined. That's going to bring up second down and 10.
Second and 10. Ball is on the Colonial's 41-yard line. We have 4:42 to go here in the third quarter. 14-13 is our score.
Timeout, Cheltenham.
And
that's
Cheltenham will call a
timeout.
It's their first timeout here in the second half. As I'm sure they'll be wanting to work out their penalty issues, and I'm sure for PW that will be a talking point as well. Both teams have dished out a number of penalties here. To a lot of yards lost.
Ladies and gentlemen, Plymouth White Marsh High School reminds all fans that we all play a role in the education of our students, parents, fans, and people in the community, all set an example for students, whether they are aware of it or not. Help rekindle the spirit of citizenship and set a positive example in everything you do, both here at the game and in the community. Good sportsmanship is what sets our school apart. Plymouth White Marsh High School thanks you.
The running play, but they'll be pushed back down the field a little more. And there's another flag on the field. I believe this is three straight plays with a flag. And for both teams, this is unacceptable football to have this many flags.
Face mask against the Colonials.
Face masking penalty on the Colonials.
5 yard penalty.
Cheltenham will advance 5 yards here. It's just been so many yards giving up. 5, 10. It all adds up over the course of the game, especially with the volume of penalties we have seen on both sides.
Ball is on the Panther. Colonial 41-yard line.
Are you actually talking to someone?
Talking on broadcast.
It's going to be second down and 10.
Second down now. Second and 10.
Hey, I'll watch the stream. I'll keep it level. I need to check the statistics. Continue.
See what the penalty is here. I believe there's just another one called. My goodness. Here we go. Looks like we'll be getting an official win. So there was a penalty. There might not have been one. Yeah, guess there wasn't. Looks like a couple players are coming in for Cheltenham, though. And so we'll go again here. We're at 2nd and 10. Play is a rushing play. And Cheltenham will be stopped. We won't gain much out of that one.
Aiden O'Brien.
Aiden O'Brien able to stop the run.
On the tackle. Gain of 4. Bring up 3rd down and 6 for the Panthers.
3rd and 6 now as the Panthers
ball placed on
4 yards
the
there. It is in Colonial territory now and on their 37-yard line. PW looking to hold them here. Don't want to let them get too close even if they don't get the first down because open up the opportunity. Here's a pass going down to a Cheltenham receiver. This one will miss, though.
Pass
is incomplete. And there is another flag on the play. So we're waiting for the flag rolling here. I'm telling you, if I had a nickel for every flag here, I'd probably be able to attend homecoming with that money.
Man downfield on the Panthers.
It sounds like an illegal man downfield on the
that
Panthers.
Penalty,
it'll set them back.
Is declined.
No, they'll be declined by PW. So it'll keep it at 4th and 6.
That's going to bring up 4th down and 6 for the Panthers. Ball's placed on the Colonial 37-yard line.
On the Colonial 37-yard line. Probably too far for the field goal. And it looks like they might be going for it. Doesn't look like they're going for the punt here. Yes, they will go for it. There's a pass. This one will go out.
That
land in no man's land and miss. And it'll be a turnover on down. So PW will now take over
on
their own 37-yard line here.
The Colonials will take over.
2nd and 10.
Yeah,
1st and 10.
Ball on the Colonial 37-yard line.
14-13, 2:47 to go in the third quarter. After this, it's just one more for one of these teams to run away and establish a lead. BW sets up, and here's the play. It looked like it was
O'Brien,
a rushing play
keeper,
there.
Good for 4 yards.
Aiden O'Brien will gain 4 yards there. They'll move up to the 41-yard line. Second and six.
Ball placed on the Colonial 41-yard line.
Eight set. And here's the snap. It's a handoff. And
O'Brien keeps again.
Took a few more yards will
short
be gained. This one again from Aiden O'Brien.
O'Brien takes the ball to the Colonial 44-yard line.
Short game. He'll gain 3 yards there. Third and three on Colonial's 44-yard line. There's a snap. Handoff. And PW will be brought down again. Gregory Feinberg there with the carry.
Looks to be gain of one. That'll bring up
that'll
fourth
be a gain
down
of
two
one.
For the Colonials.
Fourth and two for the Colonials. And I think they're just going to go for it here. Yes, they will. We'll go with a running play here. Will it be enough for
Feinberg
the first down?
Carry.
And the ruling is no. It is not enough for a first down. That'll lead to a turnover on downs here. It's a little under a minute and a half to go now. 14-13 is our score.
Officials will call for a measurement.
And officials are calling for a measurement now. We'll decide if this is enough for a first down or not.
I think they're trying to decide if they got a first down or not.
Not for PW to get the ball.
Keep the ball.
As we wait for the official ruling here. And this one is no good for PW. Cheltenham will now take the ball here. As they're just inside PW's territory. First and 10. The Colonials.
The Panthers will take over. Ball on the
47-yard line.
First and 10 Panthers.
Just under a minute and a half to go. Cheltenham getting ready to take the ball. So far this period, no scoring. It's been relatively quiet on both sides in terms of offense. And they went for a rushing gain here, but unfortunately for Cheltenham, they will not gain much. Any issues with the flickering. Again, we apologize. There's a handoff there. They'll make a decent run, but PW will be able to stop them quickly. They might have
that's
lost the yard.
Number 34, Tommy Hannon on the play.
It's here.
Timeout on the play.
And there's a timeout on Cheltenham. They've used their second timeout. One remaining right now in the half. Under 30 seconds to go. We'll be 3rd and 13 when play resumes.
Ball at midfield.
Ball is at midfield. 24 seconds to the end of the third quarter. And it'll be one more, unless overtime is needed. And both teams will return back to the field, and the timeout is up. We're ready to get things started once again. As there's not much time left here in the third quarter again. 24 seconds. Here's the play. Here's the snap. They're going to go for a pass here. This one's a deep one. What a throw, but it will be deflected. That pass is incomplete. Fourth and 13. The ball at midfield. I think the best move here is now just a punt. There's not much you can do from here. It's way too risky right now if you want to try to go for some miracle pass, miracle run. 17 seconds left. There's a couple people going downfield for PW to receive the punt from Cheltenham.
Back deep for the Colonials, number three, Zion East.
Zion East is back there, as well as Chris McLaughlin. To retrieve the punt. And this one will roll around the 20-yard line, just short of it. And
the
I do believe there's another flag.
At the Colonial 21-yard line, there is a flag on the play.
There's another one. Wait to see who that one is on right now.
Kick catch interference on
Cheltenham, and PW will get to move up a little bit.
15 yards,
huh? Oh, a lot more than a little bit. 15 free yards for PW.
That's going to bring the ball up to the Colonial.
It's up on the Colonial 36 yard line.
First and 10, Colonial.
First and 10, 8 seconds to go in the third quarter. And here comes the snap. It's a rushing play. They'll look to gain some ground here. Oh, but they're taken down.
Ball fumbled by the Colonials.
It's fumbled by the Colonials, actually. Cheltenham will recover it.
Cheltenham will take over on the Colonial.
It's a fortunate break for the Panthers there as they'll take over on the 29-yard line. Now every block is key. This next play will be the last play of the quarter. I think that's one of the big reasons we haven't seen a big offensive explosion from one team or from both teams. Both teams have really stifled themselves by the penalty. They've lost a bunch of yards from it. I mean, I imagine the penalty yards lost by both teams has to be over 60 at this rate, possibly nearing 100. For at least one of these teams. Something that they need to figure out here. Here's the play. They're going to go for a pass. This one is not complete. And that'll put wraps on the third quarter.
Nick
Scannapico was the one who was able to break up the pass here. 14 to 13 as we head to the fourth quarter now.
Your score.
Things look to be wrapping up now. 14 to 13. PW gonna do their best to hold on to this lead as diligently as they can. And as we wait for play to resume here. Both teams talking about Cheltenham moving down the field. And And then for a quick update in sports around the world, J.D. Martinez with the home run for the Red Sox, 8-5 is our score in the Red Sox-Rays game. Now, it looks like the football game is about to begin. Yes, surprise. There is indeed a football game going on. Both teams returning to the field now as the fourth quarter is about to begin now. 14-13, PW has the lead. They'll do everything in their power to hold on to it. Of course, the fields will reverse now, so PW will now be going down to the left side. Second and 10, Panthers will pick up where they left off. Gonna go for a running game here. We got a couple of PW defenders down there quickly, but they managed to break away from the defense. An important gain there for Cheltenham. And it'll be a first down now.
Ball is going to be placed on the Colonial 18-yard line.
Down on the Colonial 18-yard line. Things are getting tense. Here's the play. This one looks to be a rushing play with not much gain there.
That tackle made down to line number 48, Jared Colson.
Tackle from Jared Colson.
That carry good for 5 yards.
Still getting 5 yards there. Second and five for the Panthers now. Yes, they're on PW's 13-yard line. And here we go with the play now. Oh, this one is fumbled, I think.
There's a fumble on the play.
It's fumbled, and PW is able to recover it. And they catch a huge break, which Cheltenham is so close to being in scoring position right now. PW takes it right back. And with 11 minutes to go, it's big for them to start off the quarter, taking that ball away from Cheltenham without them scoring. PW's on their own 14-yard line. They've got to move up the field with some big, big strides. And I think we have an injury timeout again. I believe this one is on Cheltenham's side. I believe that's the fourth injury today. All have been on Cheltenham's side. And again, as I said, we hope everybody is okay on all sides of the field. We hope that the Cheltenham injured players will be able to return to action as soon as they possibly can. We hope all their injuries will recover as quick as possible and that they'll be healthy again. Get back to playing as soon as possible. We got
Aiden O'Brien on the carry.
Aiden O'Brien with the carry there as we were talking. And hopefully a little bit of gain.
That carry good for 6 yards.
6 yards.
Bring up second down and four.
Second and four, and we have another injury timeout. Wow, an astonishing amount of injuries today. Ball's on the Colonial 20. Yeah, there's been an astonishing amount of injuries today. We're a little over 11 minutes to go here in the final quarter, 14-13. We hope you've enjoyed today's broadcast. You know, this crowd has been, they've been a very lively crowd, a very active crowd. Still got a lot of people walking back and forth around the stands. It's a packed house today. I can't imagine trying to sit amongst the crowds finding a seat. It's like Color Wars on Wednesday, trying to find a seat. Good luck. Even when there's a ton of people down by the gates. I mean, they still wanted them back off, but 11:08, some of the PW players are starting to return to the field again. A couple Cheltenham players will return to action now. And we'll take the injured players off the field. Hopefully he's okay. Here's the play. We'll go for a run here. and they find quite a bit of open ground and will be able to make
Zion
a
East.
Big run. Zion East able to gain some
carries
ground there.
For a Colonial first down.
The Colonial first down here as they get, as they slowly get out of their own territory.
Ball.
Still got a
ball
little bit to go.
On the Colonial
41-yard line now. 10:40 to go. And here we go with the play. It's a running play here. And it looks like he'll gain a few yards from that one. Aiden O'Brien with the carry there. He gains 4 yards.
Second
and six now for the Colonials.
Ball
is on their 45-yard line. 14-13, just over 10 minutes to go. Right here's the play, and they go to a pass off here. And he's able to find some ground. He'll find a little bit of daylight, and he'll stumble just in front of the 40-yard line. That one is good for another first down, another run from Zion East. This one starts to work them back into Panthers territory. As it is on their 38-yard line.
First and 10
for the Colonials. We're starting to see that offense break through once now. It's never too late for a breakout. And here we go with the snap. It's a running play on O'Brien. He'll be able to find a little bit of open ground. He'll gain a few yards off that one.
Gain of
6 yards. Second and four for the Colonials.
Ball on the Panther 33
yard line.
Ball is
on Cheltenham 33 yard line. Here's the snap. They're going to take the ball with a bit of a run.
That's Aiden O'Brien on a carry again.
Aiden O'Brien with the carry there.
Short of the first down.
Just short of first down.
And one for the Colonials.
Third and one for the Colonials.
Ball the
don't need too much
Panther
now to move up.
Yard line.
Ball is on the Panthers 31-yard line. It looks like from up here. Players spreading out into formation. Third and one. Here's the play. Go with the running game here.
That's O'Brien on
and
carry
O'Brien
again.
Will be taken back down.
Just inside the 30-yard line.
Just inside the
That's
30-yard line.
Fourth down and one for the
fourth
Colonials.
And one for the Colonials. There's no gain there. Question is, do you go for it? I assume that you have to at third and one right now. It's a little over 7.5 to go. 14-13. You're in Panther territory, so don't need to worry about them being too close to you. And it looks like there's a flag on the field. This one might be on Cheltenham. Offsides on Cheltenham indeed.
That's going to give the Colonials a...
Colonials will get to move up 5 yards, I think.
Either
way, it is a first down for the Colonials. It is now on the Panthers' 25-yard line. First and 10, they'll reset their downs here. You start to hear the marching band come back in, I think. Oh. Whistle blown here. There might be another flag on that field.
It's timeout.
Nope.
Colonials.
It's a timeout for the Colonials.
Their
it's their first taken in this half. They've still got two more to go with a little over 7 minutes
seven
here
minutes
in the last quarter.
The
14-13. The big goal here
Colonials
is to score. That's always your end goal of every drive. But especially
13.
Right now in such a tight game where both teams have proved they can fight, they can get big gains.
Wow, we haven't break any action. Let's give a round of applause to our Plymouth White Marsh High School cheerleader.
We show a little appreciation here to the cheerleaders for PW. They've been great at keeping this crowd alive, keeping this crowd energized. I can't imagine what it's like to be a cheerleader. It must be the scariest feeling in the world, being held up there. And I have a lot of trust in your teammates to hold you up there and to catch you. PW's still talking out a little bit. Cheltenham is back on the field. And there go the PW Colonials back on the field again. A little over 7 minutes to go. 14-13 is our score in the last quarter. PW is looking to move the ball downfield. Go for handoff here. They find some open ground, and Zion East will be able to move this ball even farther up into Panthers territory. It's another first down for the Colonials.
Ball just inside the 10-yard line.
Just inside the 10-yard line. First and goal for the Colonials. The prime scoring opportunity that this team needs right now. Late in this game. There are the PW players. They have a moth in the booth. That's what happens when the windows are open. Here's the play. We'll go with the passing game, and this one will be a touchdown. Aiden O'Brien takes this one into the end zone. 20-13. The Colonials have the lead as they extend it here. It was a much-needed touchdown with just under 6.5 minutes to go. The crowd is alive. And now I believe they'll be going for the extra point here. If they can, it'll make it 21-13. That missed extra point on Cheltenham earlier will make things a little bit tougher if they get a touchdown here. Flag on the extra point attempt.
Offsides, defense.
Offsides on Cheltenham. Set another flag. You'll get a chance to do things again here, PW will. We'll go up for the extra point. The kick is. The kick is good. Extra point for PW makes it 21-13, just under 6.5 minutes to go. 6:24 to be exact on the clock. And yes, now that moth is climbing up our window. Cheltenham will get ready to receive the kickoff. Go to cheerleaders and the marching band. It's been an all right game for both sides, but of course the big glaring issue has been the penalties. Penalties really helped out PW in that drive. They were able to move up a bit on the field. I believe they got a first down off one of those penalties as well. It's never too late to iron that out. And this game isn't lost yet for Cheltenham at 21-13. A touchdown with a two-point conversion ties it back up. But even just a regular touchdown brings them within 2 points. The extra point would bring them within one. BW going with the kickoff here. And here's the kickoff. So on a medium length kickoff as it'll go just inside the 30-yard, just by the 30-yard line. A huddle of defenders there will take him down. So Cheltenham will be inside their own territory to start off their possession.
Taken down by number 81, Thomas Montemayor.
Thomas Montemayor, the one taking down the
Cheltenham will take over.
Kick receiver.
First and 10.
Their own 23-yard line.
Yard
Here's the play. They're going to go with a running play here. And they'll be able to pick up a few yards on that one.
That's number 81, Thomas Montemayor in on that
Thomas Montemayor again in on the tackle there to shut him down.
That play is good for 5 yards.
It's a 5 yard gain.
Second, down five for the Panthers.
Second and five for the Panthers on their own 28 yard line.
Ball.
Marching band is playing Uptown Funk by Bruno Mars. I think there's a rushing play there.
That pass play, good enough for a Panther first down.
And that passing play will be enough for the first down. True, I have not heard this song in quite a bit. And here's the play. They're going to go for another passing play. Never mind, the quarterback rushes out in a bit of a frenzy.
Shellingham
there.
Tommy Hannon
was able to stop the quarterback. Does not seem like they will gain all that much. No gain.
Bring up second down and 10.
Second and 10.
Ball on the Panthers, 36-yard line.
Ball on the Panthers, 36-yard line. And here's the snap. And there's a flag on the field.
Flag on the play. Procedure, Shelton.
This one is on Shelton.
Second down and 15.
Second and 15. Panthers again lose some ground here. Looks like they lost 5 yards, I want to say. Again, another detrimental penalty for Cheltenham that further pushes them back, and it makes it so much harder on themselves. Here's a deep pass from Cheltenham, but this one will land in no man's land out there.
That deep pass
was an incomplete pass.
That's going to bring up a third down.
Third
15
and 15 now in the Panthers.
Ball on the Panthers, 31
Ball
yard
is on
line.
Their 31 yard line. 21-13 is our score with a little over 4.5 minutes to go in the final quarter. Both teams getting into formation here. Here's the snap. They're going to go for a pass again. This one is caught. And they'll be able to move up to just a little past midfield, I believe. That should be enough for first down for Cheltenham.
Take it down by 19, Jimmy Foy.
Jimmy Foy is the one who's able to take him down.
That's a Panther first down.
Now we're just a little before midfield, I think. And they'll go to a handoff here. Cheltenham will be able to gain a few yards. I don't think they went out of bounds there.
A carry. Taken down by number 18, Jimmy Foy.
Jimmy Foy is the one who takes him down here.
Good for a yard.
Okay,
in
1 yard.
Nine.
Second and 9.
For the Panthers. Ball placed on the Panther. 47-yard line.
Second and 9 on the Panthers' 47-yard line. I've got a couple of seconds to the clock here, looks like. And I'll bring back the 3:50 left in the quarter. 21-13 again, our score. And here's the play. They're going to go for a pass here to the side. This one is good. Cheltenham finds some ground here. They'll find themselves out of bounds on that one. They'll be able to get a first down off of this one, I believe. And the play goes out of bounds. I believe they kept in bounds. No. Third and inches, as they were not able to fully get that first down yet. Trying to breach into PW territory. Here's the snap, and it's a handoff, and they find some open ground. Cheltenham will be taken down. But that, before they get a first down, gain some pivotal ground inside the PW side of the field. With a little over 3:30 to go, Chris McLaughlin was the one to take the carry down.
Carry is good for a Panther first down.
21-13. Things are going to definitely be down to the wire here. Cheltenham will take the timeout. That was their last timeout here. PW, I believe, has two more timeouts left, however.
Ladies and gentlemen, let us not forget our Plymouth White Marsh High School Marching Colonials.
A shout out for the Plymouth White Marsh Marching Colonials. Been busy all game. Of course, they had their performance before the game, about 20 to 30 minutes beforehand. And I think they're playing Sweet Caroline right now. Okay, I just hit the mic, sorry for that. Both teams ready to resume play, looks like.
When play resumes, Cheltenham will be first and 10 on the Colonials.
First and 10 on the balls. First and 10 on Colonials' 28-yard line, I think. Here's the play. Be a running play, I think.
Number 34, Tommy Hannon.
Tommy Hannon is able to tackle him. The carry will
give
him 3 yards.
Second
and seven now for the Panthers.
Ball in the Colonial 26-yard line.
Ball is on the 26-yard line. Play. And here's a snap. They'll go for a running play here. Cheltenham is able to move up a little bit further. I do not think that is enough for the first down.
That play taken down by number two, Chris McLaughlin.
Chris McLaughlin taking him down there.
It's going to bring up third down and three for the Panthers.
Third and three for the Panthers.
Ball on the Colonial 21-yard line.
Ball is on the 21-yard line in Colonial territory. They'll go for a pass here. The pass is intercepted. As PW will march down the field, they'll take away a big scoring opportunity from Cheltenham with 2 minutes left to go. Jimmy Foy with the interception in one of the most important times of the game with 2 minutes left to go. Cheltenham was sneaking up on the end zone. They look like they're about to score there. Now with 2 minutes, the Colonials' big focus here is keeping possession of the ball as long as they can. It does not matter if they score here. If they can run out these 2 minutes, they win the game 21-13. And I'm sure they'd love to add some points regardless. But what an interception there. This one prevents Cheltenham from scoring late in this game when every point, every field goal, every touchdown counts. So now shout out to student section. 2 minutes to go, 21-13 is our score. Here's the play for PW.
And that's Aiden O'Brien on the carry.
Aiden O'Brien with the carry there. He'll get the ball up to the Colonial 46 yard line, a gain of 4 yards. Second and six. Clock keeps counting down here. It's about a minute and a half to go. They'll hold the ball as long as they can, I think. With each play. Still, we can't get complacent. You never know what can happen. They're going to go for a running play here.
That's O'Brien on
Aiden
the carry
O'Brien
again.
With the carry again.
Takes it into Panther
so he brings
it
into Panthers territory.
Panther,
the ball is on the 49-yard line.
Third and two. For the Colonials.
Big thing here is converting, getting that first
injury
down again. And we have another injury on the field. .104 to go here. 21-13 is our score at PW Stadium. I think the fans here have gotten what they want. They got a good game here. Although, yes, there have been some ups and downs in terms of the penalty department. A lot of yards lost on both sides. For Cheltenham, it's hurt them a little bit more. They've given up some first downs, and one of those first downs allowed PW to end up scoring later in that drive. Counting down now, or a minute left in this game. I think they're just going to let the clock run out as long as they can now. Let's see. Yeah, they're going to let that play clock run down as much as they can.
That's timeout, Colonials.
And Colonials will call a timeout here. Oh, it's 23 seconds left in the game. 21-13
is
our score. Colonials looking to secure the victory here.
Who made our school proud with good sportsmanship throughout this game. We ask that all spectators continue to display good sportsmanship even after tonight's game is over.
They're asking spectators to make sure they maintain the good sportsmanship they've shown tonight.
Good night.
The play clock is back up to 25 seconds, more time than what is left on the game clock. And so I think the move from the Colonials will just be to let the clock run out, let this game finish up. It's the move that makes the most sense. Score here is 21-13, and they will take the knee to end this game. As the PW Colonials win tonight's homecoming game, 21-13. Plymouth White Marsh extends their winning streak. Cheltenham, they'll look to continue a new one. They will go down to 3-4 on the season. PW moves up to 5-1. They'll take this victory here, shaking hands at the midfield. And a couple of notes to take away before we get into some final wrap-ups. Both teams definitely have a penalty issue. We saw it come through today. We saw it hurt both teams quite a bit. I would argue it hurt Cheltenham a little bit more, definitely. But it's something that both teams need to work out. But you know, there's still time to do so. Still time for these teams to work out these issues and continue going on their runs. So as we get things ready to wrap up, as we get ready to wrap things up, 21-13 is our final score at homecoming game. And before we get wrapped up with tonight fully, I would like to take a couple minutes out to thank someone. Today is our executive producer Tom Peeler's last game with us. This is the last event he will work with us, period. Monday was the last day that he was in the school working. And let me just put it out here right now that anything I say on this broadcast will completely undersell his value to this club in my time here and in his time in here in general. Mr. Pilar has been great with getting us to get it out of our comfort zone, try new things that we wouldn't imagine ourselves trying when we walked in here. I mean, I came in here, I really was only interested in broadcasting baseball. And here I am broadcasting football today on my own. Broadcasted plenty of other sports as well. Soccer, volleyball, not hockey. Basketball is the sport. But Mr. Pior, alongside getting us out of our comfort zone, he's been able to show a great deal of passion and dedication to our projects. The same kind of passion and dedication that we've shown to our projects as well. I could spend forever sitting here. I really could spend the next 2-3 hours thanking him for everything he's done here, but I do not have that time. I do not have that time, unfortunately, but to wrap things up here, Mr. Pilar, thank you so, so much. You are going to be very missed by the new members. We will. We have all the new members, all the old members here, who I know will miss his impact. It's gonna be tough to carry on. I mean, to say we're not reeling in it still would be wrong. I mean, we're going to be reeling in this for a while, but Mr. Pilar's laid great groundwork for us to move on, and thank you so, so much. As we get ready to wrap things up for good now, a special thank you to our directors, Nick Cruz and Paige Sorrow, our assistant director, Thomas Warshaw, our cam crews, Alexis Pang, Ashley Berger, Sunson Liu, Mike Sig, Tyler Murphy, Lena Cram, and Isaac Nolte, and of course to our executive producer, Mr. Pilar. We wish you the best in your future career. I'm Aaron Chun. I thank you guys so much for tuning in. We hope to see you on the next broadcast. Tomorrow's the homecoming dance. We hope to see you there. But 21-13 is our final score for the homecoming game. We hope you get home safely. I assume you're at home watching this if you're watching the live broadcast. Thank you so, so much. We will see you again next time. Take care.